I would like to echo a little bit of what Senator Klinefelter was talking about as far as the General Assembly goes. This is the second time that I have served in the North Carolina House under Republican leadership. And there's a major difference in what went on in the mid-90s and what's going on now. I tried to explain to people last year in 2010 as I went around that this was the most important election. Well, you know, that didn't work out so well. People weren't really listening, not understanding that the reason it was such an important election was the fact of redistricting. And I had the privilege of serving as the redistricting chair the third time we did it after the 2000 census on the House side. So I understand what all that's about, and I understand what all these numbers are about. But what we've seen during these past 2 years, and when you ask what am I going to do when I go to Raleigh, first of all, I certainly hope that the House is back in leadership, because that is the only way we can really make a difference, to come and give you some preconceived notions of what I'm going to do or what I'm going to put forward is sort of premature at this particular point. But what I will tell you is I will continue to fight for social justice. I will continue to fight for women. I will continue to fight for those who are disenfranchised. And I will continue to work and try to respond to my constituents in Mecklenburg County. And I say Mecklenburg County because even though we represent districts, when you all call in, most of the time it's a Mecklenburg County type of issue, or it's a personal issue for you, no matter where you live. I don't look to see whether you voted or not, but it would be a good idea if you had voted so that I can be there and these other people can be there to respond to your needs. I won my first race, and the only reason I'm in the General Assembly is 49 votes. The recount gave me one more vote. That was 50 votes. I can win this election. I wouldn't be in it if I hadn't looked at the numbers. I cannot win it by thousands of votes. I can only win it by a few votes. That's just the way the numbers are. This has been redistricted in such a way, it's 38% Republican, 32% Democrat. They took away 20% of my Democratic base, and the rest are unaffiliated. So, as I told my friends who've been spending a lot of time out of state, I don't know if you're going back to Virginia or Maine, but let me tell you something. You get an absentee ballot or you're here on October 18th, an early vote, because if I lose by two votes, it'll be your two votes that I'm coming to see you now.